In this video, we're going to go over the CUDA Software Infinite Pre-Calculus Free Worksheet Power Functions. For numbers 1 through 4, our directions are to consider each power function, determine the power, and constant of variation. Now, power functions are all in the same form, and that form is y, or f of x, equals k times x to the n, where x is obviously our variable, k is our scaling factor, or our coefficient, of x to the n. So k is going to be our constant of variation, and our power is our exponent n. So knowing that, let's look at number 1. We have f of x, our function, equals 6x to the 3/7. So right away, we can see that our power is that exponent of 3/7, and our constant is that coefficient of 6. Moving on to number 2, our power is the exponent again, so that's negative 6 this time, and our constant is that k value or scaling factor of 5. For number 3, we're still in the form of a power function. So because we're in the form of f of x equals k times x to the n, our power is negative 1/3, that exponent, and our constant is 8. And then lastly, on to number 4, f of x equals 2x to the 5/7. Our power is 5/7, and our constant is equal to 2. And that's because we're in the form of f of x equals k times x to the n. Now for the second part of this worksheet, it says to consider each power function. Determine the domain and range, the intercepts, the end behavior, continuity, and regions of increase and decrease. So let's look at number 5. First, we'll start by figuring out the domain. And the domain of the function are the values that we're going to plug in and solve for f of x. So that's the possibility of x values, which goes from negative infinity to positive infinity. We can plug in any value for x. We are not restricted. Now, the range are the possibilities of f of x values, or if you want to think of f of x as y values. And you can see that there are no y values, no f of x values, that are negative. So we go from 0 to positive infinity for our range, where 0 is included. So our range is 0, making sure we use a bracket since 0 is included, to positive infinity. Now next, it asks for our intercepts. And in number 5, our x-intercept, where the function crosses the x-axis, is at 0, and our y-intercept is where the function crosses that f of x-axis, which is also 0. So our x-intercept is 0. Again, that's the value at which that function crosses the x-axis, and our y-intercept is also 0, and again, that's the point where the function crosses the y-axis, or f of x-axis. Now our next step is figuring out the end behavior. And that's basically what the function is doing as the x-values continue to increase or as the x-values continue to decrease. So as the x-values continue to decrease, so the limit of this function as x approaches negative infinity, so the limit of the function f of x as x goes to negative infinity, so we're looking at as we move to the left on the graph, y is going to continue to increase, so the function value is going to continue to increase to infinity. And the other limit is as x goes to positive infinity, so the limit of our function as we go larger or as we increase our x values, we're also going to be increasing our f of x values, so that will also be infinity. So now we have the domain, range, intercepts, the end behavior. Now we're going to look at continuity and regions of increase and decrease. So first, looking at continuity, remember a function is continuous. The easiest way to think of this is that a function is continuous if you can put your pencil down and draw the function without picking it up. So this function is continuous, and we're going to say the interval that it's continuous on. So it's going to be continuous from negative infinity to positive infinity. So from x as negative infinity to positive infinity. So essentially it's continuous over the entire domain. And now our last step is to see when that function's increasing and when that function is decreasing. Now if you remember, we have a minimum, which turns out to be an absolute minimum at 0, 0. So the function is decreasing up until that point. So from negative infinity to 0 in the domain, that function is decreasing. And then from 0 to positive infinity, so x from 0 to positive infinity, that function is increasing. And that is the list of attributes we had defined for number 5. Let's move on to number 6. So at number 6, we're going to start by finding the domain. And the domain are the possible x values. Now if you notice, we have a point of discontinuity at x equals 0. So x equals 0 is not going to be part of the domain. Therefore, our domain is going to go from negative infinity to 0, and then, so I'm going to use the union symbol to show that the domain does continue, but we're skipping over that 0. The domain continues from 0 to positive infinity. Now the range is the possible y values or f of x values, and you can see that f of x is always greater than 0. It doesn't quite reach 0, but it's always greater than 0, and it continues on to infinity. So our range is from 0 to infinity, but not including that 0, since it never quite reaches 0. Now next, remember it asked for the intercepts, but you can see that since we don't have x equals 0 in that domain, we're not going to have a y-intercept, because the function will never cross over the y-axis, and because the values of f of x never reach 0, we're also not going to cross over the x-axis. Therefore, there are no intercepts in number 6. Now, the next thing we need to look at is the end behavior. So, as we go to negative infinity in the x, the limit of our function, f of x, again, that's as we go to negative infinity, it's slowly approaching 0. And as the x values increase to positive infinity, the same occurs. Our limit, or our end behavior, our function is approaching 0. Next, we need to deal with continuity. And like I said, we could see that x equals 0 was a point of discontinuity. And the type of discontinuity that is infinite discontinuity. Because y is increasing to infinity, we have our point of discontinuity, and y was reaching infinity on that other side. Therefore, it's an infinite discontinuity at x equals 0. And then lastly, we're going to see when this function is increasing and when the function is decreasing. The function is increasing from negative infinity up until 0, and then the function is decreasing from that point of discontinuity of 0 to positive infinity. And those were all the attributes it asked us to find in number 6. Let's continue on to number 7. Number 7 and 8 are slightly different than 5 and 6, being that we do not have a graph. But feel free to use a graphing calculator to help you understand this problem. So again, we're going to find domain and range, so we'll start with that. Now, I've already graphed this function for us on a graphing calculator so that we could see it visually. You can see that for our domain, x cannot be equal to 0. So just like in number 6, we have our domain going from negative infinity up to that point 0, and then from there, 0 to positive infinity, but that 0 is not included. And for our range, our y values never quite reach 0, but they go up towards positive infinity. So our range is from 0, but not including 0, to positive infinity. Now we need to look at our intercepts, and notice that because our range never reaches 0, and because our domain excludes 0, there are no intercepts. Next, we're going to look at the end behavior of the function. As we go to negative infinity, our function approaches 0, and as we go to positive infinity, so moving to the right, our function also approaches 0. So the limit of our function, f of x, as x approaches negative infinity, is 0. So as we look at values towards the left, our function approaches 0, and the limit of our function, f of x, as x approaches positive infinity, that is also 0. So again, the limit of f of x as x approaches negative infinity is also 0. Now we're going to look at any discontinuity, which we know occurs at x equals 0, and that's going to be an infinite discontinuity. And lastly, we're going to see when our function is increasing, so the domain at which our function increases and the domain at which our function decreases. Our function is increasing from negative infinity up until that point of discontinuity 0, and then it decreases from that point of discontinuity to infinity. So it's increasing from negative infinity to 0, and then decreasing from 0 to positive infinity. And lastly, we're going to be looking at number 8, which number 8 is very similar to 6 and 7. You can see that again, the domain is from negative infinity up until 0, that 0 is excluded, and then from 0 to positive infinity. And our f of x values never quite reach 0, but they go all the way up until positive infinity. So just like in 6 and 7, our domain is from negative infinity to 0, and then from 0 to positive infinity, and our range is from 0 to positive infinity, because we never dip into those third and fourth quadrants. And because we never reach 0 in the range, we do not have an x-intercept, and because we never have 0 in the domain, we don't have a y-intercept. That function never touches either axis. Therefore, there are no intercepts. And again, just like in 6 and 7, as our x values decrease, our function approaches 0, and as our x values increase, our function approaches 0. So the limit of f of x as x approaches negative infinity, as it's decreasing, is 0, and the limit of our function f of x as the x values increase, as they approach positive infinity, the limit is also 0. That is our end behavior. And as far as continuity goes, we know that it's an infinite discontinuity at x equals 0. And if you're confused at any point on infinite discontinuity, please refer back to a previous worksheet or to my tutorial lessons on maymap.com. And then lastly, we're going to see when the function is increasing and decreasing. The function is increasing from negative infinity to 0, and then the function is decreasing from that discontinuity of 0 to infinity. So increasing from negative infinity to 0, and then decreasing from 0 to positive infinity. And with that, we wrap up our power functions worksheet. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I or one of your peers will respond as quickly as possible. Also, if you haven't already, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share it if you think somebody else will find it useful.